Everybody wants to be a beast, so it's time to step up.
I'll make excuses. I'll make excuses.
I came back with a bang. I came back on the scene. I came back on the scene. Like say I'm lying with my back on the scene. I came back with a bang. I came back on the scene. I came back on the scene. Like say I'm lying with my back on the scene. I came back with a bang.
Hello guys, welcome to another episode of Succeed Sundays. We are here today with Daisy.
Hi.
Who is obviously, you know, a bodybuilder. Do you like to go to a bodybuilder?
Yeah, we can say bodybuilder.
Bodybuilder.
We're building the body.
Yeah, we're building the body. We're just going to ask you a few questions on how she got started. So, first question, how did you get started?
I got started 2 years ago, just on a whim. Went to the gym, didn't think I'd enjoy it, and lo and behold, I did. And I've been doing it ever since, and I've not really had a lot of time off, as in months at a time. I've had about the odd week off, but it's just become a part of your life, doesn't it? So
what about the diet side to it?
I'd never done a proper diet before until the start of this year, so in 2015, January. And I started my first proper prep diet. I did a 16-week diet initially,
yeah,
and then it ended up being a six-month diet, four shows, two medals and a trophy. Yay!
Well, basically, I dieted for a show once last year, and I think I did it for over 6 weeks. But near the end of the prep, it started to get to me. What would you tell up-and-coming bodybuilders or women that are bodybuilders that are prepping for a show? Like, how to stay focused and not break?
Picture what you want to look like, or picture what you want to achieve, and just keep thinking about it.
Yeah.
And it is hard, it's really hard, but it's just a case of mind over matter. And if you give up, you're never gonna succeed, you're never gonna get what you want. So when it gets hard, just imagine yourself winning, or imagine yourself doing what you want to do, or looking like what you want to look like. And you'll do it. It's just a case of mind over matter. Just don't give in. Never give up. Otherwise, you're never going to get there, are you? That's the best thing, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. People should take a lot of information from that. Also, like, what do you feel like as a woman in a male-dominated sport? Because obviously, you know.
Do you know what? I think everyone who does this sport has mutual respect for each other. Because you're all in the same boat. Whether you're male or female, it's hard. Whether you're a man dieting or a woman dieting, it's hard. So I think that it's a good sport to be in.
Yeah.
Like, no one bitches on each other. I think everyone really does just help each other. So I don't feel like I'm a woman in a man's sport. I feel like we're all men.
It's just like, you know, the outsiders who just getting into working out probably look at a girl like, shh. Do you know what I mean? Like, the simple-minded people.
Yeah.
So what do you feel about them sort of remarks? Like Dana Bailey, she went for a lot of criticism.
Yeah.
People calling her a freak and getting to her. She posted that video on YouTube about it.
Yeah.
Like, what are your thoughts on that?
Oh, it's people who don't have a clue. That's what it is. It's people who don't know what they're on about. But then if they actually met these people that they're taking the mantle out of, they realise that they're just like any other people. In fact, they're probably more determined people than you'd ever meet. More inspiration. Like, Dana Bailey is such an inspirational person. So never knock anyone till you know them.
Exactly. And also, you know, through the sport, people don't understand, like, training, it also trains the mind. It makes you more of a focused person. Like you said, after you did your show, you feel a lot different now. You feel like a different person.
Well, because when I started, I just doubted myself, and I just thought, I can never do this. But now I've done it, you can do anything. You actually can do anything if you put your mind to it. It has made me a lot stronger. I think it's made me a better person, and I think I appreciate not just life, but everything, food, like going out with my mates, my family. You appreciate all those things a lot more when you've been through something so, like, hard. Like you say, it's hard when you get so far into your diet because you feel like crap.
Yeah, you do.
But you don't realise how many people you've got supporting you. So
that's I think in bodybuilding, it's good to have support because people just see the guy in the hoodie in the gym acting like he's, you know, just there solo and thinking that he goes home and he's on his own. You need that, you know, a backbone behind you, like a team.
It's a lonely game, though. Yeah, it is a lonely game because it's very selfish. It's all about yourself. You can't worry about what other people are doing in their prep. So it's nice to have good people around you who do support you because you need that when you're dieting. You need it in life anyway.
Yeah, you do need it in life.
When you're dieting especially.
But it's also, with the bodybuilding, like I said, it's a lone sport. It's because a lot of people that don't train, they're looking from the outside, they don't understand. Like I could look like you, you know what I mean, in 2 years, or if I took steroids.
Mm.
Which is like, no, you can't. Regardless of how many steroids you take and how many years you train, if you don't dedicate yourself to the sport, you'll never look like this.
No, that's right.
It's an art form, and I think people need to understand that and appreciate like what we put our bodies through. It's not easy.
I think a lot of people do. Well, a lot of people say, I work in the gym, so I know a lot of people in there, and they've seen the person I've become through the prep, and I think they appreciate it now because they've seen the struggle that I've been through. And so a lot of them now appreciate the sport a lot more, even though they don't do it, they just train for to keep fit. But a lot of them now appreciate what you have to do to get like that. So it's just about changing people's mindsets, I think that's all.
So just before we go, is there any wise words you want to give to, you know, kids coming up or bodybuilders coming up?
Never give up. Believe in yourself, trust the process, and just do what you enjoy. Enjoy life.
Well, that's another episode of Succeed Sundays. My name's Nathaniel Shaw and here's
Daisy
signing out.
Bye.
I came back with a bang. I came back on the scene. I came back on the scene. Like say I'm lying with my back on the scene. I came back with a bang. I came back on the scene. I came back on the scene. Like say I'm lying with my back on the scene. I came back with a bang.